Hello, everyone, and welcome back to RimWorld. I know some of you thought that you may never be back in RimWorld, and for that I apologize. It should have never taken me so long to continue this series. Consider the last episode, episode 10, to be the mid-season finale. It did end on a bang, didn't it? The alien centipede burning to death. The Gatling cannon spraying all around us, threatening to take our colonists out, but we managed to dance around those bullets masterfully. Salt has been sent to pick up what remains of that Gatling cannon to add it to our arsenal. It nearly burned up in the blaze that consumed the centipede, but it's safe at 24% stability, durability, what have you. And today, we start a new direction for the colony. We'll mark this return to RimWorld with a brand new goal. Well, it's a new old goal. Remember early on when I suggested we might turn this colony into a thriving drug cartel? So it begins. And it starts by taking a look at the Smokeleaf leaves that we have already stored in the colony's safe walls. 168. They need to be rolled up into smokable joints. And to do that, we need a crafting spot, which I will put here in what is to be the recreation room, which will be used for more than just pool. It'll be used for recreational drug activities. See? Now when I want to actually roll them up, we'll add a bill. Why don't we just do that now? I'm not gonna say that we're gonna do something and then not do it. We're gonna actually do it. So we're gonna do forever. I guess there's no reason not to, right? Do it forever and store them in the fridge. That's the plan. So if we have the crafter assigned, which we don't, I guess that won't start until we get someone to craft. This is a crafting spot, after all. It does make sense. Now, who should it be? Looks like our hauler is Taz. So how about Taz, when you're not hauling or plant cutting, you can start crafting. But it looks like somebody else has a passion for this, even though they have lower skill. Dinah, currently our warden, good at construction and repair and tailoring. Master of all trades, as it appears. I'm gonna set this as a 2 for now. It won't get done for quite some time because we're gonna be doing a lot of construction, but it is there, it is possible. Now we need to start decking out these empty rooms. Take a look at what time of the year it is. The 8th of winter, it's still frigid outside, 25 degrees below freezing. Well, 25 degrees and it is below freezing, I should say. But the 8th of winter means we're about halfway done with this RimWorld month and we're going to soon arrive back into spring, and these outdoor crop areas will start functioning and we'll be able to grow our own smoke leaf instead of just using this tiny supply that we got from cargo pods. What did we get from this drop? A bunch of granite blocks? Okay, I guess we'll be able to use those potentially for construction. Now back to the empty rooms. One is to be hydroponics. The other, recreational activities. But neither of them need any stones here. So Opal, you're good at hauling, right? Yeah, you've got 8 out of 8 haul training. Why don't you go pick up one of these giant rocks with your teeth and take it outside? No, maybe later. Now we got a problem here. Ooh, he did it. Awesome. I didn't really expect you to do it on command. The problem is that these hydroponics basins are gonna need to be pushed down a little bit. Why is that? I remember, if you take a look at the sun lamp, which is what's gonna be required to grow these hydroponic plants, look at the area of influence of that light. So if the hydroponics are outside that influence, they're going to not receive enough light to actually grow the crops. So let's build that square in the middle, like I'm gonna want it. And I'm gonna need to actually deconstruct a bunch of these walls and lower the total area that we're using here for the hydroponics room by at least, I think, 2 blocks. Let's go 2 down, then move it on over. And what that's gonna allow us to do is take more advantage of this light. Because if we've got more light down to the south, I want more hydroponic basins there to continue to grow those crops. I think we'll need to mine a little bit of rock wall out as well. Now back to the production. We have a bunch of steel, 1,000. So that's going to be enough to build for us 10 hydroponic basins. And I believe colonists can walk over hydroponics basins, so if I really wanted to, I could stack them all the way down in a column. But I don't want to do that. I don't like that. I like having room for the colonists to walk around, even though they don't need it. It just makes me feel good. I'm going to arrange it like this, where they can go on this little aisle, the middle aisle, or the bottom aisle. Either way. And then 2 more. Just need to mine out 1 little block, and we can queue up the last remaining hydroponics base. So that's how many in total? 4, 8, 12 hydroponics basins. It's not going to be enough to sustain us through winter, but it will give us just that extra little bit of buffer before we completely run out of resources in the next winter, if we're lucky enough to live that long. So I'm going to let them get to work, doing what they're doing. We're just going to go at 3x speed here unless something bad happens. And in the top room, I said I want it to be recreation, and that means a little bit of joy. Billiard's table will be able to fit as soon as these two rocks are moved out of the way. And our primary hauler, again, is going to be Taz, who is asleep. So we're going to have to pause on that recreation room and wait until later. Hydroponics basins are not just about steel and components, even though that's what we need to get them built, and more than just blueprints. They're also about power. Each one requires 70 watts when it's connected up to the grid. For reference, a standing lamp is 75 watts, so it's not really that much, but when you get 12 of them side by side, it does add up. And worst of all, the worst offender, is the sun lamp needed to get the crops to grow. 1600 watts! So we're going to designate power to toggle that off until all of the hydroponic basins are ready and waiting to start growing the crops. I want to make the most use of our power supply, and also we haven't even planted any of the hydroponics plants yet. I don't think we have good enough power cords stretching through the walls. So I want to do that as well. And we're still missing one piece of the wall here, I think. Did you guys forget about this? I'm going to get Ivana on this task, because it's very cold in here for no reason. Wall is reserved by Polo. Okay, Polo is bringing in the last bit of steel to build that and some of the cabling up. Good. Another issue is going to be keeping this area warm. And we do have some corner pieces to help with that. So let's get the temperature and a heater in here. We probably also are going to need a cooler at some point, but a heater will be a good place to start. We might even need two because this is a huge room. But we'll start with just one. My mouse over says it's 27 degrees indoors. It's because until just recently we had a chunk of the wall open to the outside elements. It is warming up ever so slowly when heat escapes from this middle hallway where it's 68 degrees through the open door and into the room. All right, almost done. Only needed 3 more hydroponics basins in total and someone to grow the crops. Polo the Oaf is asleep. That's probably why none of this has actually started. Now, what do we want to grow here? We don't want all of this to be potatoes, do we? We want a handful of them to be potatoes. Probably these top 6 will constitute our potatoes. We'll do the bottom 2 as heel root, probably, and that reminds me, we do have enough open space for the 12th and final hydroponics basin to be queued up. Want a handful of these to be something other than potatoes. Let's do, perhaps, some strawberries. A little bit of variety, and then maybe the other 2 as rice. Trying to keep things nice and split up. Corn is what we're going to transition to outside once we get a bigger stockpile than 410 raw food. All finished. Everything is hooked up and ready to go. We're just waiting on Polo. Where are you, Polo? Having a nice meal and then coming down here to start planting all the crops. Wonderful, that means we can toggle this light on and watch as all the batteries deplete one by one. Rare thrombos and an escape pod. All right, we're gonna stay away from you. That much is a given. Olive here has crash landed on the southwestern portion of the map. From a character standpoint, she's a great combatant from a melee and shooting perspective, has a bloodlust. It's a rush from hurting people. She's twice as likely to start a social fight. I don't know if I like that. She's neurotic, which means she's a fast worker, and gains pleasure from chemicals. Oh no, she hates the idea of that. Avoids alcohol and pleasurable drugs. Well, you might have a problem here in our colony. Bare minimum, I will rescue you. Our warden is Dinah. So we're gonna have Dinah come out and capture. We do need to start growing the colony by whatever means necessary. And if that means taking somebody who abhors the idea of our cartel, well, they're just gonna have to learn to like it. Oh, whoa! Surprise explosion in the hallway. We may have a bit of an issue here. The good news is all the colonists are on duty, ready to go to work. I'm gonna put out this fire, and they're not going to get heat stroke. Isn't that right? Talia has caught fire. If anyone would like to help with that, you forgot one person. How's your health? Burns on the arm, leg. Okay. Not too bad. Not too bad. Sorry to wake you up like an hour before you all were supposed to. You see what I see? Smokeleaf leaves times 8 on the crafting spot. They are about ready to be turned into our first ever joints by Ivana. When do you wake up, Ivana? Right now. Good. Do we need to rebuild any of our power conduit? Oh dear. Yeah, you know what that business means? It means that we forgot to turn off 2 of the power switches. Simple rookie mistakes. And there is no air outside whatsoever. Well, that's not good. It means hydroponics are completely useless right now. Until a gust of wind picks up and starts powering everything. Which just happens to be right now. Good. More cargo pods down here. A bunch of food, 250 panther meat. A gift from the heavens. Taz, come down here and gather up as much as you can. I know you're meditating right now, but you're back to work. I think we got just enough wind to start producing a surplus. We've only got 18 stored. It's ticking one up at a time. All it takes is just a little bit of darkness and all the crops die. That simple. The heater goes out, the light goes out, all the crops are disappeared. Dinah! Dinah made our first Smokeleaf joints! How about that? Let's look up some information on these. Prepared in small rolls for smoking. Improves mood, but also increases appetite. Probably don't want to do that in the middle of winter, do we? When we're low on food, they're going to eat more. A slow movement and can produce a dependency. Can be produced without the equipment. Okay. Is anyone actually on these right now? I know Dinah's making them. You are a master crafter. Is anybody... How do you tell if they're on drugs or not? That's what I want to know. Is it under the assign tab? Current drug policy. So everyone is apt for social drugs. That means somebody could have already smoked these. I'm just going to circle around the moodlets and find out if anybody has. High on Smokeleaf. Polo the oaf. I'm like, stoned, man. I got tons of joy, though. I'm enjoying myself so much. Feeling great for no apparent reason. I think the reason is apparent. Dinah the Drifter, also high on Smokeleaf. Well, we've done it, ladies and gentlemen. But the problem is, we are consuming our product, which I guess is okay. We gotta test it out. We gotta make sure that it's good enough to sell on the streets, right? Wake up times 11? An addictive stimulant. Fills the need for rest. Allows users to work for extended periods without getting tired. Now, is this considered recreational drugs? Is this social? I guess I can edit them to tell them what they're allowed to do. Smokeleaf and beer. Those are the only two. These are the lightest. Makes sense. So I'm gonna let them pick that up and we can sell that. Some more drugs to add to our stockpile. Do they spoil? I guess they don't have a refrigeration need. They just will deteriorate. I always forget who the hauler is. Taz. Consuming a simple meal? All right, I'll let you do that first. But then I need you to go out here and pick these up before they are destroyed by the weather. Now that I have a prisoner in our cells, might want to check to see if they're freezing to death. It's 62, which is not freezing, but there's no heater system in here, so I've got 2 heaters queued up in each corner, and a vent going in on one side, and now a vent going in on the other, and that'll take care of our little problem here. I guess I could make a vent to the outside hallway, but I think we need a heater anyway because we're only maintaining 66 degrees in this big, vast open area that we've got here. Oh, speaking of open areas, we can make a pool table now. Should be enough space. I don't want to make it out of wood, though. Probably want to keep using steel, but we don't have any steel either. We can make it out of granite blocks. That'll be fancy. I like that. And on the sides, I could even make a chess table if I want. So let's make another slate chess table. How much is it gonna take, 70? Do we have enough to make the billiards table? It requires 80, we definitely do. So power is okay. Looks like we now have a rescue dog in the form of Opal, who just finished training, which is exciting. Oh yeah, speaking of prisoners, I'm gonna figure out what to do with you. Let's do chat and recruit. Doesn't look like you're too difficult to recruit. You're in pretty good health. No injuries whatsoever. Yeah, power, we're about halfway on the first set. I've disconnected the second set just as a precautionary measure. Now we just speed forward. What do we do with all these smokable joints? Are we gonna smoke them all before we can sell them or grow anymore? That's the real question. And do we have enough power now to turn on hydroponics? I think we do. So I'm gonna toggle everything in this room and see how, I heard it. Did you hear it? I did, Taz. We're getting to witness it firsthand. What smoking a joint in RimWorld actually looks like. He's relaxing socially. 50 years old. Just left it there on the chair. We need to make some ashtrays for our colony. You can't just leave your joint on the chair. Take it with you, put it out somewhere. Give it to somebody else. Don't just leave it there. Now what else are we gonna do in the future? Well, it's almost the end of winter. It's the 11th right now. Gonna work on growing some new drug crops and starting a new research. That sounds like a good plan. Drug production. That does sound like what we need, doesn't it? But first, before we make the drug lab, I think we need microelectronics to make a comms console. That's gonna enable trade. So before we make the drugs, we need to be able to trade the drugs that we already can make. Makes sense, right? But my microelectronics basics are 700, whereas drug production is only 500, that's quicker. So if we figure out how to make the drugs, yeah, that makes more sense. Do the drugs first, then while we're growing new drugs and preparing them, we'll be researching microelectronics. And by the time the drugs are done, this research will be done. It makes sense in my head anyway. Another escape pod! Solar has crash landed here. Great social skills, good at construction and cooking, seems like a valuable member of society, just incapable of dumb labor, and has a depressive trait. Seems to not really be in a good mood very often. Iron-willed, however, won't break down, so perfect colonist. Ivana, capture Solar. We have a new prisoner in need of our attention. Two potential new colonists have fallen from the heavens. A chunk of spacecraft has fallen and landed nearby. Free components. There's no alien centipede hiding inside of this ship. Apparently we did not make it back with Solar for some reason. Let's try this one more time, Ivana. You can do it, I believe in you. Anyways, guys, hope you enjoyed this return to RimWorld. I think we've accomplished a lot today. We've got the hydroponics room all the way set up. We've started crafting smokable joints from the Smokeleaf stocks that we have saved up after all this time. Winter's almost over and we'll begin growing even more. Research has begun on new ways to make new drugs, and I'm pretty excited. Thank you all so much for watching and returning. Let me know what you think, of course, down in the comments below, and what you want to see next time. My name is Etalyx, and I'll see you soon back in RimWorld.